Aloha, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us this afternoon for what is another virtual construction update meeting. Very important that we have these. I also wanted to let you folks know that this is sort of, while it is virtual, we still want to be able to answer your questions. There's a couple of different ways that you can do that. If you're logged on right now to Facebook, you could leave a question in the comment section. So right below the video, leave a question there. If not, you can also send it to us via email, and that's info@honolulutransit.org. info@honolulutransit.org. Don't worry, we've got a few slides as we continue our presentation that will show you and let you know how you can go ahead and reach out to us and ask questions. So we want to let you know kind of what is on the agenda today. I'm going to give you a project overview, and we will have not just a project overview of sort of the entirety of it, but then we also want to give you more of the sort of meat and potatoes and let you know exactly what's happening right now with our airport guideway and stations, as well as our city center utility relocation. As we said, super important, your questions. We've already had a few questions that have been submitted that we're going to get to once the presentation's over. But please, if you have a question, feel free to send that question to us those two different ways, whether it's in the Facebook comment section, or you can also email us at info@honolulutransit.org. Afterwards, we're hoping that you folks, we know that you're interested in the project. We want to know more. We have a survey that we're hoping you can take for us, and we will have that survey and the information on that as well. And then, as we said, just the fact that we are going to be able to answer your questions. So very important. Let us go ahead and get started. And so right now, I want to introduce to you the boss of the project, if you will. He's the executive director as well as chief executive officer. We welcome in right now, Andrew Robbins. Good afternoon, Andy.
Yes, good afternoon, Jai. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this virtual session, this construction update. We're very happy to be presenting that to you today. We have a lot of information to share, and as Jai mentioned, we look forward to comments and questions that you may have. Just want to acknowledge some of our guests today that are joining us. I believe that, is Mayor-elect Blangiardi on the line?
No, he's not.
Okay, he was not able to join us today. I believe we might have Council Member Elect Tulba. Is he on the line? Okay, if not,
yes, sir. My understanding is that Augie is on the line. Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Well, welcome. Congratulations to you on your election, and welcome aboard. And then I believe we have Corey Chun from Council Member Waters' office. Welcome to you. And I believe we have four board members from the Hart Board of Directors. Our board chair, Toby Martin, should be on. Our HR committee chair, Lynn McQuarrie, I believe, is on. And then our project oversight committee chair, Glenn O'Hara, I believe, is on. And then one of our newer board members, Kika Bukowski, is on as well, as I understand. So welcome to all of you as well. I'm not sure if I missed anybody else, but if I did, my apologies, and welcome as well. And we look forward to hearing from you, and if you have any questions, we'll be happy to answer those as well. Okay, why don't we get started then? I'm going to present the overview for you, and then we'll have other members of the team come up and present other aspects of the project as well. So once again, my name is Andrew Robbins. I'm the executive director and CEO of Hart. And the first slide shows an overview. I think most people are probably familiar with this this map, but this is our system map that shows the 21 station system that we are building right across Oahu, west to east, from East Kapolei all the way to Ala Moana Center. And you see here the 21 stations. We now have Hawaiian station names for all of the stations, and we're very excited about that as well. As part of the project, we are building 4 park and ride lots, mostly in the western portion of the project. And we have a 43-acre rail operations center located in Pearl City. And that facility is where the trains are stored, where they're maintained, where the control center is. And that facility is up and running, and its staff today, pretty much around the clock at this point. And we'll explain some of the activities that we're carrying out day in and day out on the rail project. And before we leave this slide, I'll just mention that the technology being used for the project is quite unique in the US. It's a, in the industry, what we call an automated light metro system. So it's sort of a hybrid technology between what you may know as heavy rail, like the New York subway or the BART system in San Francisco. And then also not quite light rail. Light rail is typically street running system. This is a completely grade separated system, mostly elevated, and the trains are driverless. You see driverless trains around North America, primarily in airports and, for example, at the John F. Driverless rail system that's being implemented in the United States, probably most similar to the Vancouver SkyTrain that runs up in Canada. If you will, if we can advance to the next. The rail system. So these are in the westernmost part. Running from East Kapolei to Aloha Stadium, we have our excuse me, just one moment, and I'll continue just in one moment.
Hey folks, before we get back to Executive Director Andrew Robbins, just real quickly wanted to let folks know the two different ways we had told you a little earlier about sending in any sort of questions you have. You're going to hear a lot about this project, about where we are, about where we're going. If you have any questions, two different ways. If you're on our Facebook right now, you can, in the comments section, you can put in your question. We're monitoring that, and we'll get a chance, hopefully, to answer all the questions that we're going to get. We have done this in the past with the virtual updates, and we get a lot of great questions. Folks that are interested, if you've been out west, you see that these stations certainly look like stations. They have the canopies up, elevators are up. The testing is going on right now 24/7. So if you've got a question, you can put it in the comments section. But also, if you want to email it to us, info@honolulutransit.org, info@honolulutransit.org. And we'll keep reminding you as this presentation continues. We've got a few different slides there. So if you're not able to remember, don't worry. We're going to take care of you. And as we said, we get a lot of great questions. This is a way we're kind of able to bring you an update as to what's happening right now along this system. And so if we could, I'm going to welcome back in Mr. Robbins. Andy, if you want to continue. Sorry about that. I just had to break in real quick just so we can make sure that folks got their questions in if they want to get those questions answered. So take it away, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Jai, and I apologize for the interruption. So before I get into the station slides, let me just give you a high-level overview of the project and how it's proceeding. So if you start out west between East Kapolei and Aloha Stadium, the elevated guideway is completely done. It's all constructed and it's actually up in operation for our testing activities. As I mentioned earlier, the Rail Operations Center in Pearl City, the 43-acre facility, that's also complete and in operation. And we are rapidly completing the first 9 stations out west between East Kapolei and Aloha Stadium, and I'll walk you through those slides in a few moments. So that first 10 miles is the subject of what we call interim opening number 1. And we're going through all of the actual final testing activities right now. There's an extensive test program where we test the trains, the controls, communications, all of the various systems to make sure that everything is functioning the way it's supposed to. All of the technologies are integrated together. So that testing will continue for some time leading into next year. And that culminates in a what we call trial running, where we run all the trains in those first 10 miles as if it were in regular service, just without passengers. Once we complete all of those tests, everything passes, then we go through the final stages of our safety certification process, where we are working with Hitachi, with the city, as well as with the State Department of Transportation, all with the goal of receiving the safety certification. And once that's complete, we'll be ready to hand the project over, the first miles, to the City Department of Transportation Services, who will then see fit to start the actual service and allow passengers to start using the first 10 miles. So that's an exciting goal that we anticipate next year to occur. So the next phase of construction is between Aloha Stadium and Middle Street. And anybody that's kind of driven out on the H1 Viaduct would see this construction rapidly progressing. We're actually about 77% complete with that project right now. It's about 4.5 miles of elevated guideway and 4 stations. Those stations are all now integrated into that particular contract. And you'll see the guideway pretty much complete now between Middle Street, past the airport where the new rental car facility is. And then it's also being progressed in another stage over by the Middle Street side of the alignment. And then the contractor, STG, will finish the guideway construction in the beginning part of next year. We'll have a continuous 4.5 mile elevated guideway complete. The next operation is putting all the track work on above, which you can't see, but it'll be up on top of the guideway, all the track work. And then they are completing all 4 stations as well. So that project is, as I said, about 77% complete, and that's progressing very, very well. And then the last portion of the project is what we call City Center. That's from Middle Street to Ala Moana Center. And as I'm sure you've seen in the newspaper and in media, it's very complicated, and we are having difficulties, as been reported in the newspaper, in terms of all of the major utility relocations that have to take place so that we can actually build our elevated guideway. And a lot of those utilities are on Dillingham Boulevard, where it's very complicated. Massive number of utilities along Dillingham, water, sewer, gas, telecom, and then you see all the overhead electric lines as well. We have to deal with all of those. Very complicated, and working very closely with the city to sort all that out and come up with a plan that will get us going and really start accelerating the work through that area. And once we get a head start with the utility relocation, we'll be going out for procurement once again to identify a contractor to build the guideway and stations. There's 8 stations in the City Center portion. As I'm sure you've read in the newspaper, that guideway and station work was associated with what was called the P3 procurement, but we made a decision to cancel that procurement, and we'll be re-procuring that over the course of the next several months. So that gives you kind of a high overview of the project. Now, let me go to the next slide now and just quickly walk you through the stations that are associated with the western part of the system, the first 10 miles. So these are the 9 stations. That will be the first to open next year. And a few years ago, it was decided to construct these stations 3 at a time. So we have contractors working on under contract for 3 stations at a time. The first contract is what we call West Oahu Station Group. And these stations are virtually complete at this point. They have all of the features that you need for a rail transit system. They have the platforms, the escalators, elevators, and the overhead canopies, which provide shade when passengers are up on the platform waiting for the train. So these stations are virtually complete. We're just doing final punch list, as it's called, work at this point on these first 3 stations. If we go to the next slide, you'll see the next 3 stations, which we call the Farrington Highway Station Group. Again, just about 100% complete, all the elements. And I should mention that all of the 9 stations out west. I have fare collection and fare gates all installed. So we're going through the testing of those technologies as well. So these three stations, again, almost 100% complete, going through punch work and checking out the various technologies and doing all of the testing. If you go to the next slide, you see the final three stations of the first nine, which we call the Kamehameha Highway Station Group. This contract was let out a little bit later than all the others. So they're at about 95% complete at this point. Probably the Aloha Stadium station is the last one that will be complete. Currently, we are putting up the canopies right now, those fabric canopies. And this is a very unique element of the stations out west, which have these fabric canopies that look like sails. So I think it's quite a striking feature of the stations. So we're completing that work on Aloha Stadium right now. And we should see these stations pretty much complete by January of 2021, so that we can continue all the testing through this area and get the entire first 10 miles ready for the interim services I mentioned before. Okay, if we go to the next slide, I referred to all of the testing activities. So that is what we are doing right now in segment one, which again is the first 10 miles from East Kapolei to Aloha Stadium, from the Kualakai station to the Halawa station. We're actually testing trains now Monday through Friday, 24 hours a day, and then also on Saturdays and Sundays for a couple of shifts as well. So if you're out west, you will see trains running. Unfortunately, we can't allow passengers on board yet because it's all still in the testing phase, but you will see multiple trains running. I believe we've had as many as 4 trains running at one time. And so the Hitachi folks particularly are well advanced in working on all of the testing program, and together with HART, we monitor this very closely. So hopefully you'll see, you go out there and you'll see the trains running. Really indicates that we're on our way to the first interim opening after all these years, and I know we all look forward to that. Okay, with that, I think it's time for me to hand it over to Ben Myers, who will walk you through the airport guideway and stations part of the project. Ben?
Hey, thank you, Andy. Real quick, this is Jai Cunningham once again. Just wanted to let folks know before we get to Ben and we get to the airport section of this project, if you've got your questions, we had said 2 different ways that you can get in touch with us. So if you want to send us an email, we've got folks who are monitoring that. It's very easy, info@honolulutransit.org. Or if you're watching right now on Facebook and you want to leave a question there at Facebook, just go to the comments section right there, and you can leave that question. We're monitoring the Facebook feed as well. So as soon as we get done with the presentation, we get a chance to answer all of those questions that get sent to us. So we appreciate that. Now, as Andy had just said, right now we want to welcome in Ben Myers. He is with Shimmick Trailer and Granite. He's got much more on the airport guideway and stations. So Ben, if you could, take it away.
Thank you, Director Robbins. Thank you, Jai. So like Sly said, I'm Ben Myers. I'm the Deputy Construction Manager for the STG project here. First slide here is a few highlights of the project, but I want to point out some of the key features in this picture here through the airport real quick. You can see the blue stuff in the front is our platform girder forms as part of the station. So that work's ongoing there. And you can see the Watts Tower Crane for the Conrack facility they're building, and our gantry kind of off on the left there for some of the guideway work. And pretty neat how the guideway and station, everything is integrated through the existing features of the airport. It's pretty seamless deal there. So pretty neat when people get to see it. But to the highlights, like Director Robbins said, we're approaching 80% complete with the total project. Looking to be complete, substantial completion in December of 2021. And right now we've got about 3.5 miles of the total guideway completed. We're working in 3 different locations currently with Span Construction for the overhead guideway. And the station work will be ongoing throughout. Those are kind of hard to put together, pretty complex, pretty integrated. And so they take a little bit of time, but we'll be tracking those down to the end through 2021 there. So next slide, please. Kind of a bigger map here. You can see the Makalapa station at Radford is ongoing with Pedbridge steelwork and track is ongoing through that area, track installation, as well as work at the other three stations, the airport station, Lagoon Drive, and Middle Street, all currently under construction in various phases. Guideway installation currently in the airport and out on Ulana Street has started up in the last week or so, and we're continuing the guideway installation across the Middle Street merge there at H1 and Nimitz and Dillingham through all the ramps there. So pretty complicated stuff there. Drilled shafts are virtually complete on Ualena, except for one location. And we have a few more left to do out on Dillingham and Reach E, what we call Reach E, towards the end of the project. And the YY loop area will start drilled shafts first quarter of next year and complete those out. And that'll complete all the drilled shafts on the project. Column construction. The gray column sticking out of the ground. They follow the drill shaft operation. So that's ongoing there on Ualena Street and out there at the Dillingham area. Next slide, please. Overhead view of the progress there at on the station at Pearl Harbor area. We've got curb and gutter and roadway work is ongoing as it becomes available along Cam Highway. Our primary focus right now is on the track installation in this area, as well as work on the Makalapa station. And because of some of that work, you'll experience some intermittent lane closures during the days now and possibly some detours at night for the structural steel work. And you should expect some lane closures during day shifts in the spring of 2021 as we install the permanent street lighting and new traffic signal facilities at the intersections along the stretch. Next slide, please. Here's the yellow picture. Here is the yellow item in the picture is the bed bridge that's currently getting installed. That'll take you from the fare gates to the elevator platform and then ultimately up to the train boarding area when the station's complete. So that work is ongoing now. We're hanging steel at night, so we have some detours through that area. But this station's currently about 22% complete, so almost a quarter of the way done. Like I said, the pedestrian bridge is ongoing, so expect some detours there. And we're looking to have this completed in the fourth quarter of 2021 with the entire station there. Next slide, please. The next area of that we have a lot of work focus on is in the airport. We've got lane closures between parking and garage exits and H1 on ramp and the rental car return area, basically nightly through this area. And we'll be doing that process of moving traffic through those areas through 2021 as we finish all the, I'm sorry, through the middle of 2021, as we finish up the new road improvements that are a benefit to the guideway construction as well. Next slide, please. As I was talking about, our Segarect operation, or what we call Segarect, which is the guideway construction, is getting ready to traverse across the Paia roadway area, which is the second level exit from Terminal 2 to the H1 ramps. So you'll have intermittent traffic impacts and some closures there through starting actually this Friday, and continuing on pretty heavy through the next week and lightening up towards the 18th of December. That'll be necessary for us to deliver the concrete segments and get the bridge built over the road. That's the red area that you see in the picture there below. So look out for those road closures and please slow down for in the cone zone there. Next slide, please. Here's a overview of the progress at the airport station. Like I spoke earlier, you can see the platform girders, that form system in place. We're making our first pour this Saturday. So that's the, will be half of it. And then on the, towards the end of the month, we'll pour the other half and we'll remove that form system and start some of the other steps of the work. And those platform girders are going to be directly underneath the fabric canopies that Director Robbins was speaking of. As you can see, they're in all of our stations over here as well. And we're also currently working on the concrete column work for the pedestrian access on the Mackay side of the station to get you to the terminals. So next slide, please. The airport industrial area is a busy spot for construction work right now. We've got guideway installation going on, coming out of a parking area, one of our laydown areas, and moving on to Atlanta Street. We've also got concrete columns being installed on the Mackay side of the road, and we're getting ready to start some what we call straddle bents, which are beams that run transverse to the road that hold the guideway up closer to Lagoon Drive in the near future here. So lots of activities there. The street is currently in a one-way direction, and that is westbound. And we have sometimes some flagging operations during the day to try to speed up some stuff and nightly lane closures there in that Ualena Street section. Across on the Diamond Head side of Lagoon Drive is it turns to YY Loop, and everybody's working real hard to finish up the utility relocates before the end of the year here, so we can get the third parties in and Spectrum and HTI and HECO to get their work done, and we can progress the guideway through the Lagoon Drive station area and tie it into where we've already built over there in the park. So like I said, lots of activity. We've got very patient residents or tenants in that area, so everybody's working real well together. And a big PI effort, public involvement effort from our team as well as Hart's team. So it's been a challenge, but we're working through it. And I'd like to thank all the business owners and tenants in that area for being patient with us. Next slide, please. The station, as you can see in the picture on the left, you can see the structural steel is being dressed out now. We've got some concrete work going on, and we've built what we call the ancillary building in the back left corner of that photo that houses a bunch of the electrical equipment. We're currently working on the Mackay side where that dewatering pit is, putting in the underground utilities that serve the station, and we will be working on those through probably another month or so, and then we'll start coming out of the ground and basically building the mirror of what you see on the Malka side of the road. So in the rendering, you can kind of see what it looks like. And basically, two sides of the station are virtually the same. The Mackay side will have a little kiss and ride parking area for convenience. And right now, we're about 20% overall with the station. And once again, looking to be running through 2021 to get this thing to the finish line. Next slide, please. As I spoke earlier, the overhead guideway is coming through the Nimitz Viaduct ramps at where the viaduct drops down into Nimitz and goes the other way if you're heading westbound. So we're currently working our way across the road. We're real close to the freeway ramp from Nimitz to Dillingham currently. So you can see the machine sitting up there right now, and it'll progress through that area over to the Middle Street station, looking to be across the Dillingham Nimitz or the Nimitz area first part of next year. And then we'll have some follow-on work after that with minimal closures, but should anticipate alternating lane closures through this area up through the first of the end of this year, first of next year. And all that work's being done at nighttime. So be careful going through there as it might change day to day from which lanes are closed or which ramps are closed. So be cognizant of the street signs and the directions from the traffic control devices. And we're working that area Sunday through Thursday so we can stay off the road on the weekends there. So, next slide, please. More traffic impacts that I wanted to make sure everybody understands were kind of what I spoke about earlier and what we have going on over there on Dillingham as you approach the Middle Street area, Nimitz Highway and Kamehameha. So just traveling in that westbound direction, you'll be detoured to Kamehameha Highway. And that'll be ongoing through this year And it just changes all the time. So please just stay focused and pay attention to driving in that area. There's a lot of neat activities to look at. Next slide, please. The eastbound contraflow, what we call contraflow, where we have one of the eastbound lanes in the westbound or the Malka side of the road in that location, will be ongoing through June. That's towards the end of the project. That allows us to get the guideway built and take the machine down if we need to there at the end of the job. This is the area on Kamehameha Highway between Middle Street and, I don't know how to say that street name, so I apologize. I don't want to butcher it, but you can follow us on our Facebook page there and get the updates for the most current construction updates for traffic stuff as shown there. So next slide, please. And here's some of the pictures of the progress at the station work. The picture on the left is October. We're continuing with preparations for building the platform girders in this location. We're working over the water, so it's pretty challenging. The concrete columns are coming out of the ground, and the work at the bus terminal, the transit center there on the top of the picture is ongoing. As you can see on the rendering on the right, the pedestrian bridge that gets you from the bus terminal to the rail platforms. We're actually getting ready to set the Malka half of that on about middle of January. So there'll be some closures through that. You'll see the pedestrian bridge start to take shape, and that's one of the key components to getting the ridership to and from the train and getting the thing in one of the interim phases of opening up. So, and it's a pretty big accomplishment there. Next slide, please. That's all I have. I'll throw it back to Jai. He'll have another update on how you can submit some questions. So thank you.
Hey, thank you very much, Ben. We appreciate that. And we appreciate the experts that we have who are not just presenting, but they're going to stay on online, if you will. That way, if we have any questions that concern the airport guideway station contract, any of the work that's going on, we'll have Ben that can answer that. And so we want any questions that you have. And we know that there are a lot of questions, you know, on a daily basis. People are asking us, calling us, sending in questions. Two different ways that you can do this. If you're on Facebook right now, in the comments section, you could leave a question there if you want, or if you want to email it, really easy, just go to info@honolulutransit.org. Those are the two ways that you can get questions to us. And as soon as we're done with the presentation, we want to answer all the questions, so we appreciate your interest in the project, and we appreciate your getting a chance here to get an update from our experts. And so now, we want to talk a little bit about city center utility relocation. And for that, I'm going to bring in Mark Gravel. Mark, take it away.
Thank you, Dry, and thank you, Ben, for your report on the airport center there. Again, my name is Mark Gravel. I'm the project manager on ART's behalf for the city center utility relocate projects, what we call CCUR. The first slide here is an indication of the areas, but before I go there, I just to go over what CCUR really is the entire, well, the primary goal of the project is to clear the areas for the guideway shafts. So as you saw in the previous presentation and what Ben alluded to is they put these drilled shafts in that go deep into the ground that are placed there to support the guideway, and they're anywhere between 100 to 150 feet apart. And part what CCUR is doing is clearing all the utilities out of the way of those shafts, as well as any aerial utilities that may potentially be in conflict with the construction of the guideway structure. So in doing so, we have to quite often move the underground utilities as well as make room for the above ground utilities. So the way we've split up the city center area, which goes from Middle Street to Ala Moana, is we've split it up into six numbered areas, where area one, as shown here, is the Dillingham Boulevard corridor. So that we further split up to 1A, 1B, and 1C, 1A being Middle Street to Mokuaea, 1B, Mokuaea to the Kapalama Stream, and 1C, Mokuaea to Kaahi Street. So that's I'll be using them. I'll be using both the street name and the area name, just so it corresponds with the information that's being provided. So after Area 1, Dillingham, we move to Area 2, which is Kaahi, which is the smallest section of the smallest area of the CCUR project. And you'll see it transfers and gets, it's essentially an off-ramp off of Dillingham and provides us access to Area 3, which is Nimitz. So next slide, please. Okay. What you see here on the left-hand side is the remainder of the Nimitz corridor. And at that point, at the diamond head of the Nimitz corridor, we switch to Area 4 or Halakuila. And that goes on and switches over to Area 5, which is Queen. And again, Area 6, which is along Kona Street. And then at the very far right end of the pink shown on the drawing.
I think we may have lost Mark Gravel. So just to let you guys know, just to give you an idea, we're used to having until 2020 hit and COVID, we would have these on a quite a regular basis where we would actually be out into the field, get a chance to visit with you folks to give you updates. Well, because of COVID and the fact that we're really limited, that has led us to use Facebook as a platform to keep folks updated about the work that's going on, the scope of work that's going on. And that's why we're having these virtual meetings, so that we can keep you updated on exactly what is happening and how quickly it is moving along. So let me see if we have Mark back online just yet. And actually, you know what? Ask and you shall receive. So we actually went down the hallway and got Mark Gravel. So I'm gonna step out of the way and let Mr. Gravel take over as he tells you more about the CCUR, City Center Utility Relocation.
How far did I get?
Let's see. So you were just getting done with the sections. So now let's find out a little bit more about where we stand.
So as long as I got to the end of the City Center project where we have the end terminus at the Ala Moana Mall, we'll keep going from there. Now, I don't have nice renderings of the stations and different levels of construction of stations, but I do have pictures of the work that's going on in an effort to get CCR completed. And here's an indication on the left-hand side of some waterline work and on the right-hand side of some asphalt removal in anticipation of placing trenches and removing and replacing utilities. So I've got a couple picture slides just to keep things interested and keep things moving. Okay, and this might be of interest to most people. It's the schedule, our current schedule for CCUR as of the end of November. Of primary note, I think with all the news coverage that we've had with our work we've been completing on Dillingham and the fact that we've removed the construction forces from Dillingham and returned that to full access, except for where at the Middle Street end where SPG mentioned that they were working. We have gone to a redesign in this area. If anybody's gone down Dillingham, and I'm sure most of you have, and you look up, you'll see just how many utilities are in the air in that location. And the intent is to put the vast majority of those underground. Now, the problem is that underground has already been populated with water lines, sewer lines, drain lines, other telephone lines. So as we moved forward with the design, we ran into some snags with maintaining the appropriate amount of distance between each individual utility. So right now, at this point in time, we are in the middle of what we would call a redesign, where we're ensuring that we're creating the right distances between those utilities in an effort to get everything into the ground. That being said, right now, what we're anticipating is an April of 2022 return to construction for the Dillingham portion. This, if we keep following our community updates, you'll find that these dates will be tuned in to match when we anticipate these specific areas to be the redesign to be completed. So beyond Area 1, which was Dillingham, we see Area 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, which is the remainder of the work. Now, we'll see on a subsequent slide just how far along we are in those areas, but if you follow down the right-hand side, we're looking at completion in some of these areas as early as late 2021. So this gives you an idea, if you're in those areas or commonly travel through those areas, when you can expect construction to be ongoing and when you could hope to have our portion of the work completed. Keep in mind, after these dates, they still have to put the guideway up, so it's not the end of construction, it's the end of the CCR portion of the work. So next slide, please. Here is the current completion of each of those sections. So in Dillingham, we got a good start in on Area 1A before we went to redesign. So you can see we're upwards around 13% there. Area 2, which it's the smallest area, but it's also the one where we've had earliest access to do the work. And we've moved along quite well in that area. So you can see we're over 60% complete there, to the point where we are going to be in the process of actually cutting over some of the utilities. So actually removing some of the infrastructure, the cables that were in the air, and actually putting them underground. So that's a milestone for that section of the work. Areas 3 through 6 are still awaiting final design, and the work that is ongoing there is fairly minimal, but it's in anticipation of receiving completed designs in early 2021. So I'll move on to the next slide and share some pictures again, a little bit of a before and after shot, where you see the removal in front of a business and then the subsequent repaving. So as we go along, we do our every effort to bring things back to as good or better condition as the work proceeds. So the intention is that once all these utilities are in and the guideway structure is in, we're sitting with an extensive amount of new infrastructure around all the work. If you go along the east section, or sorry, the west end of the work where the guideway is completed, you'll see a lot of street improvements, a lot of visual improvements throughout those areas, and that's a benefit to the city and the state as a whole. So this is part of the work that HART is bringing and the rail is bringing to the community. My next slide discusses the design, and it shows really, this is the critical path to CCR, and it's what's critical to us getting back to work in the street to do the actual utility relocates. The chart, the matrix that I've shown here is rather complicated, but the highlights of it is the Dillingham corridor, which is what this page shows, the expected redesign is pushed out about 15 months. So we're looking at late January 2022 with the design before we can go back to work in those areas. So that corresponds with the anticipated startup date that I provided earlier. It'll be early January 22, but like I said, stay tuned. We'll be updating that in subsequent community meetings that we have. The rest of the second utility design slide is to show areas 4 through 6. Areas 4 through 6 are Halakuila, Queen, and Kona. The anticipated completion of the utility designs in these areas is in February of 2021. So from that point, when we get the design complete, we go, we hand that to the contractor. The contractor goes and gets permits, and then they go to work. So there's a little bit of delay from this time to when the construction starts and when the construction will start in earnest. But this gives an indication as to what we call the critical path. The essential items, the priority right now with CCUR is to get this utility design done. And right now the dates are early 2021. So in and around the middle to end of February, we should start seeing the designs come out of there. Now, you may have noticed that I did not comment on area 2 or 3 with regards to design, but areas 2 and area 3 are the design is complete to the point where we have permits to go to work. So there is work ongoing there. The one outlying design that's required is for traffic signals and street lights, which come towards the end of the construction work and will be incorporated when they become available. So that's the status of the design for that area. With one last note, with the delays we're in the middle of with regards to the redesign of Dillingham and the pause we're taking with the procurement of the guideway structure, between those two items, it's given us a chance to reset how we went to a contract on CCUR. So a big undertaking that we're taking at heart is to go out to tender or request pricing for the remainder of CCUR. The reason this is important at this point in time is because when we originally went and went out for a contractor to do the work, we did not have complete designs. So that being said, there was a lot of guesswork and assumptions that had to be incorporated into the pricing, and our intent is to come back with finalized designs that the contractors can identify, quantify, and then come up with a more competitive price to do the work. So our anticipation is to get that together and starting with areas 4 through 6. So as I said before, the design for that is anticipated early in 2021. And have those contracts available for award in that time period for areas 4 through 6. So again, Halakuila through to Alamoana. So I believe that's the end of my slide presentation. I'll stick around here for questions later and I'll pass it on to Jai. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. We appreciate that. And as you can tell from the presentation, there are a lot of moving parts. So this, you know, when we tell folks, it is 20 miles with 21 stations. So there are a lot of things to keep you updated on. If you've got questions, and we already have some that have been sent in, two different ways you can do that. Do this if you are on Facebook in the comments section. We have someone who's monitoring that. So if you want to write a question in the comment box, we can get that question answered for you. Or if you want to send one in via email, it's info@honolulutransit.org. info@honolulutransit.org. And now let's go ahead and get to some of those questions and hopefully get some answers for you. Let me see. I need the glasses here. Okay. First question comes in via Facebook. It is from Derek Stevens. When can I expect to ride the rail from Aloha Stadium to Kapolei? And for that, we're kind of having a team effort here. So we have socially distanced, but we have three or four folks who are in here, and that includes the head of our public involvement department. So do we want to send this to Andy? Director Robbins, if you want, go ahead and answer that question. Again, Derek Stevens wanting to know when will he be able to ride from Aloha Stadium out to Kapolei or Kapolei to Aloha Stadium?
Okay, thank you, Jai, and thank you for the question. As I mentioned earlier, the first step really in terms of allowing passengers to ride and opening the system to passengers is for HART to complete, together with our contractor, complete all of the testing and then get into the safety certification process. And once we are safety certified for those first 10 miles, we essentially hand over the completed system to the Department of Transportation Services at the city, who will then decide when it is time to allow passengers onto the system. And I can assure you that together with HART, DTS has been working very diligently to get all the operational readiness tasks ready to go, as well as the Hitachi Rail folks. They've hired a number of people already. Those people are being trained and all being readied for the operations and maintenance of the entire system. Our current schedule shows sort of by the middle of next year that we will be ready to hand the system over. We're going to try to expedite that as much as possible. And my understanding is that the city will be ready to go into actual operations and maintenance pretty well soon after we turn over the system and it's all safety certified. So let's say around the middle of next year as an estimated time when to look forward to riding the first 10 miles.
Thank you, Director Robbins, for that. Okay, we've got more questions. This one comes to us via email, again, info@honolulutransit.org, and it's a question from Linda LeGrand. Would it make fiscal sense to end the rail line at the suggested downtown gateway? Hasn't this project, as it is being built today, so far veered from what we agreed to early on, as far as proven that we should consider another more financially viable option? And so I want to welcome in once again our CEO and executive director to answer that. Andy, if you don't mind, I'm going to put my microphone on mute. If you could handle that, what Linda LeGrand wants to know is it financially viable to end at what they call the downtown gateway?
Well, I think the first thing to understand is that HART and the city have a contract with the federal government to complete the entire rail system. It's under what's called a full funding grant agreement. And that entails completing the full 20 miles, 21 stations, so all the way to Ala Center. And I know the Westside folks really want to see it completed to Ala Center. That said, we will be needing additional funding to complete the project. That's not established yet. So we are looking at a phasing plan where we would build the city center part of the system in phases based on available funding. So it very well may be that we reach Civic Center at some point. We may have to wait for additional funding to go the rest of the distance. But I know the mayor has stated, and I have joined him in saying that we are committed to finishing the entire system to Ala Moana Center. There's really no intent to cut the system short. It may have to be built in phases, but the commitment is still there to complete the entire system.
Thank you, Andy. We appreciate that. We have more questions. And again, the two different ways you can do that, you can send it to us via email that's info@honolulutransit.org, or you can also reach out to us on Facebook. And I want to say a big aloha out to Councilmember-elect Augie T. I know he is joining us this afternoon. We appreciate you tuning in, Councilmember Tolba, or Councilmember-elect Tolba. We appreciate that, and thank you for the support that you have here. Another question that came in via Facebook, and this is in the downtown area. When do you anticipate installing the columns and guideways through downtown? And I don't know if... Andy, do you want to take that one?
Okay, sort of tied into the last answer. We will need additional funds to carry out construction through the city center segment. So that is a bit unknown at this time. I'm sure those discussions will continue into 2021. But we do anticipate being under contract for the city center third or fourth quarter of next year. There's usually about a 6-month design process that would follow that, and then construction could begin depending on availability of funds. So we're looking at the 2025-2026 timeframe when I think you can anticipate actual construction activities occurring in the downtown area.
Thank you, Andy. And we appreciate all the folks who are dialed in, who are catching this on our Facebook Live. I want to say, and I say this with all due respect, I want to say hello to an old friend, and I mean that in the kindest of ways, Nestor Garcia. He's from the office of Congressman Ed Case. We appreciate the help that that our congressional delegation is able to give us, and we know that there is a great deal of interest. Okay, some other questions that have come in. A Facebook comment from Ray Ignacio. He says, thank you for your shout out and support of the project. We want to thank you, Ray. And how is it going to help with traffic congestion? Ray. Okay, I thought that might have been a, well, that's a great name. I like it either way. It is one of those names that could be, you know, kingly, Ray or Reyna, king or a queen. Okay, another Facebook comment that comes in from Eric Irwin. He's with the Kalihi Palama Neighborhood Board. Thank you, Eric, for your question. This is regarding what appeared to be construction workers possibly setting off fireworks on a rail site. This is back on November 20th. We're going to look into the situation and with the contractor, and we will follow up. Activities like this should not occur within HART construction sites by staff or the public. Thank you for bringing that to our attention. That's something that, and a little later, we will give you a number of different ways that you can stay updated with us to find out more about what's going on, the different ways that you can reach out and contact us. Okay, another question that came in via Facebook. This is from Scott Wilson. He wants to know, why didn't STG bid on the city center section when it was opened up for bidding? I'll throw this back out to our executive director. I know that this has been a question that's been asked a great deal as far as that P3. Andy, if you don't mind, just let us know why that city center section in STG did or did not. I know that with procurement, it's not that easy that you're allowed to say who might have had a chance to bid on this, but I'll let you answer that.
Well, I think, you know, the P3 procurement has been canceled, so I think we can talk about it now. And STG is actually a consortium of three major construction companies, Shimmick, Trailer, and Granite. They make up the STG. So when we talk about bidding in the city center portion of the project, Shimmick actually ended up having a conflict because they were acquired a couple of years ago by a company called AECOM, which was involved in the design, preliminary design of the guideway in city center. So Shimmick actually faced a conflict there. But Trailer and Granite were involved in the P3 procurement, so those companies were pursuing the follow-on work in city center.
Thank you, Andy. We appreciate that. Another question that's come in, and I actually can handle this one because we've had a chance to really ramp up this program. Sarah sent us a question via email at info@honolulutransit.org. Wants to know, what is Shop and Dine? What's that program, and how can I participate as a small business in the program? Is it free, she asked. Yes, Sarah, it is free. A couple of different ways you can reach out to us. And as I said, as we advance the slides a little bit, I can show you, besides taking our survey, I just want to show you real quick a couple of different ways that you can get in touch with us. The hotline, it is manned 24/7. 808-566-2299. That's one way you can reach out to us. We can put you in touch with Shelly Thomas. She sort of is the program director. She kind of gets all the program going. We have now more than 100 businesses that have joined. And so that's one way you can do it, is give us a call. But there's also reach out to us at, you know, and leave your contact information. Send us an email at info@honolulutransit.org. We can get that information given to Shelly, and she can get in touch with you and get you signed up. Yeah, it's really important for you to know it is free. So it really gives chance for, you know, the great thing about the program is it really supports small businesses and businesses that are along the rail line while construction is ongoing. We're aware that it can really put a dent in business. And so this is one way that you can reach out. It's a discount program, so all you have to do, and a lot of these businesses already have discount programs in place, like a Kama Aina Tuesday or a Senior Day, where you may get a discount there. just simply put it down in writing, we get your signature, and we are able to promote that. And so it really does help small businesses who maybe don't have the kind of capital, the kind of funding to try and put together commercials or to try and do some of this. So yeah, get in touch with us. Like we said, there's a couple of different ways there. There's a hotline at 566-2299, or just send your contact information to info@honolulutransit.org. Okay, more questions and answers we have. Let me step out here and see. Okay, a question from Jim McDonald. Okay, this one I know is for Director Robbins. How can this project possibly take 13 more years? Andy, if you don't mind taking this one.
Okay, I think I'm there now. Right. So I know the 13 years was put out via comment from the city, but I believe they were looking at kind of a scenario that was sort of the worst case scenario. As I mentioned earlier, we are going to need additional funding to complete the project to Ala Moana Center. So the timing, the schedule is dependent on the funding, but we are looking at scenarios of completing the project in the 2027-2028 timeframe. So there's different factors that go into the schedule. Funding, certainly funding availability is certainly a key one, but given that we are able as a community to work that out, we do believe there's a path forward that will get the project done in 2027, or perhaps as late as 2028.
Thank you, Andy. We appreciate that. Again, if you've got questions, you can send them to us two different ways. Either leave a comment and we can get to that on our Facebook, or you can also send it in info@honolulutransit.org. Okay, another Facebook question. Want to know, why are you doing CCUR work in areas 3 through 6 when the new mayor may cancel the rail after downtown? We will throw this one back over to our executive director, Andrew Robbins. Mr. Robbins?
Well, again, as I mentioned earlier, the commitment from Mayor Caldwell, and I joined him in that communication just yesterday, actually, with the FTA, is that there's no intent to cut the line short. We have the full funding grant agreement, which essentially is a contract with the federal government to complete the full 20 miles, 21 stations. So therefore, HART has a mandate to do just that, complete the 20 miles. Until there would be any kind of change in that mandate, we're focused on getting the entire project completed. And we're focused on finding the lowest cost and the best schedule to do it. So that's why we do look at the work in City Center. We do have to get the utilities relocated first. Dillingham Boulevard is, as was explained by Mark, is extremely complicated and is going to lag the rest of City Center in terms of our ability to complete those relocations. So from Eva Leigh to Ala Moana Center, we believe we can get those utilities out of the way quicker, and therefore we're looking at a schedule that does that and follows the guideway work in that area. This, of course, is subject to more public consultations, presentations, conferring with the City Council, among others. We have a mandate at heart to figure out the best way to complete the entire project, and we'll present it accordingly.
Thank you, Andy. This one I think is for Mark Gravel. This is a Facebook question coming in from Mike Boscheman, a friend of the project. We've had a chance to talk with him on a number of occasions. And then I also give a shout out real quick to the Mililani Trojans. Go Trojans. Mililani, very proud graduate, is Mr. Boscheman. Okay, Mike wants to know, am I understanding correctly that the underground utility relocation in Area 3, that's downtown, is forecast to be complete by December of 2021, but it's only 6.8% complete to date. Mark, do you want to take that one? And actually, while I'm letting you speak, I'll go back and find the slide that kind of shows some of the time frame of work that's being done.
Yes. So, Mike, that's pretty astute to pick that up. But yes, the key thing with that area three, is a lot of the relocation was actually removals, which have been ongoing. The new installs, although we're only 6.8% complete, are actually relatively, there is not that much relocation to complete in that area in comparison to a lot of the other areas. So once we get the final design in place and are allowed or have the permitting in place in order to move forward, you'll find that it moves forward very quickly. And that's that is what the schedule reflects. So I hope that answers your question.
Thank you, Mark. We appreciate that. I'm going to go back now slide-wise and get us back to our questions and answers. We had another question come in via Facebook. Again, thank you guys for these questions, and there are some really good questions and are critical for us to share with you guys. This really is a two-way street. So while this is a virtual meeting, this is our way to get so many of the questions you might have answered. This is a question coming in from Scott Wilson. The Outdoor Circle is concerned about the removal of the trees on both sides of Dillingham Boulevard. This is at Honolulu Community College. What is HART doing to mitigate the loss of what are mature trees? I'm going to step out of the way. Ryan Tam is going to jump in. Ryan, if you don't mind, just real quick, introduce yourself, and then I know you've been and know a lot about this area.
Hi, my name is Ryan Tam, and I'm the Director of Planning for HART. With regards to the trees on Dillingham Boulevard, so again, we know that these trees are very important to the community. And that they actually were possibly planted by the founder of the Outdoor Circle back in the 1930s as part of this kind of the City Beautiful movement. In terms of mitigating the removal of the trees, again, we're still working through the plans. We do have commitments to repurpose the wood, so making sure that the wood from the trees goes to cultural organizations. We also have commitments to plant replacement trees as close as possible to this area. So we're looking for locations for that. And lastly, when we do plant the replacement landscaping that goes in along the guideway in this area, we do have commitments to share that those plans with our consulting parties. And again, the plans for this area are evolving, and so we're obviously we're trying to save as many trees as we can. So thank you.
Thank you, Ryan. We appreciate that. And also, Ryan touched on it a little bit with the sort of beautification that goes on. I know Mark had spoke to that as well. What you also have to realize, and probably the best example is of this, if you go to Halaulani Station, that's the station that is at Leeward Community College. They have gone out of their way for a lot of the native landscaping to be used there. So if you get a chance to see it, it really is something that's part of the program to really beautify the area and also pay homage to the area. And so it really is a neat sight to see. Another question that we have coming in. I know I messed this up earlier. Want a big shout out to Ray Ignacio. We appreciate you following us here on Facebook. Okay, let's see. Another question coming in. Oh, okay. You know, we had talked a little bit earlier. Sarah had asked and inquired about our Shop and Dine on the Line program. We have a number of different business programs that we have in place. And so we also wanted to tell you about shopthecommunity.com. We have, it really is a website where you can get a chance. Like we had said, a lot of times small businesses that we're trying to support, they don't necessarily have the budget or the opportunity to be able to create a website, do things like that. It can be kind of costly. What it is, if you go to it, check it out, shopthecommunity.com. It's our chance to help these small businesses produce a little bit of content and to give you a chance to know what these businesses have to offer. And it is, just like Shop and Dine on the Line, it is a free program. A couple of different ways that you can get in touch with us, that hotline number 566-2299. You can also send an email with any sort of contact information that you want to info@honolulutransit.org. As we said, not just for Shop and Dine, but also shopthecommunity.com. Go check it out because it is a free program. And if you're a small business, whether you're a smoothie shop or whether you have a clothing shop, something like that, anything, it really is a diverse program that gives you a chance to have a little bit of an online presence without what could be really costly. So go check that out. Again, shopthecommunity.com. Okay. I want to say thank you. Thank you for all of the great questions. We appreciate that. Now, we had asked a little earlier if you could do us a favor. We appreciate it, and we want to know more. We have a survey, and it is very easy to go to. It won't take but just a few minutes, and we would deeply appreciate it. If you go .honolulutransit.org/survey, go.honolulutransit.org/survey, we would really appreciate for you to weigh in and let us know what you think. Some very important questions for us that'll give us an opportunity to figure out kind of what is important and what we need to focus on as we move forward. We appreciate that. We told you about this, shopanddineontheline.com. It is a free program. We have more than 100 different vendors who have now signed up, everything from delicious popcorn to beautiful little boutiques, things like that. Go ahead and give it a check it out, because a lot of these small businesses are along the rail line, and we know how COVID-19 has really put a real major strain on businesses over the past 6-8 months that this has been happening. And so a lot of them, this is really an opportunity for them to get some attention and for it to cost them absolutely nothing. And it's a chance for you to get a chance to see some of the discounts that are being offered and take advantage of them as you not just give them business, but you get a chance to get a little benefit as well. Stay connected with us. There are a couple of different ways. We have weekly traffic advisories. We have an e-blast that you can sign up for. Just head to our website if you want to sign up there. It's www.honolulutransit.org, and then social media as well. We also told you about the rapid response hotline that we have, 808-566-2299. Any email inquiry you have, you can send to info@honolulutransit.org. And of course, social media inquiries on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter as well. You can see there some of the different handles that you need to go to. Reach out to us there. We have we have folks who are constantly monitoring that and get a chance to answer you. So there's a number of different ways you can reach out to us and get in touch with us. We appreciate that. Well, that wraps up yet another construction update virtual meeting. We will continue to have these. Obviously, the COVID-19 has kind of thrown our outreach into a bit of a virtual mode, and so we don't get a chance to really go out and give you presentations with large groups of people like we used to do. So for now, just stay tuned to us, all those different ways that you can find out. And as we set the next construction meeting, we will, of course, keep you updated and let you know more about that. We thank you for all the good questions today. We hope that we got everything answered. And obviously, moving forward, continue to stay in touch with us. And we want you to have a wonderful Tuesday. So thank you for joining us. Have a great day. Aloha. Okay, folks, for anyone, all of our different experts and everything, we appreciate it. We're clear. We thank you, and then obviously appreciate the you guys staying tuned and appreciate your knowledge that you're able to share with the folks today. So thank you.